Now, what I meant about what we are going to do here, you know, cinema as a playground for children, what I thought that I would have loved a larger share of children here in this room.
We all are.
Then there was some caring about it. Caring about it, ultra ka upar ka aapke voting card dekhe, I will not believe it. Wo nahi chalta hai. Bachche mein really much.
Yeah.
Dil se nahi. Those who don't grow up, I don't blame. But what I meant was, ki really jo bachche hai, wo, why do we, for instance, keep this bar, cinema study, it has to be a postgrad course. It's not a rocket science, like some of the scientists who come here and talk. It's fine for them that you have to actually crack your physics and do all the training things and unravel mysteries of the world. But there is no mystery in art. So what we do, we need a lot of us, is we just share cinema with the youngest of the young. First of all, I'm so glad that Rinki is here, because I keep sharing Do Bigha Zameen made by her father, the great Bimal Roy, all the time, and try to demystify it and call it a children's film, so that there is more empathy generated in the viewer room itself, wherever I share it with children. So that whole thing of children means Kele ka chilka, you know, pisla gira, that's children's film. That, I think somebody has to tell this nation that that's not happening. That's part one. Part two is, viewing is an experience, but what about making? I mean, what stops you from, you know, trying out a very simple storyline and then try and cover it with whichever medium you have access to, from a cell phone to a tablet or anything. And you have your video edit softwares loaded on all your computers. So what should stop a child from first viewing cinema, so that the child is weaned away from Bollywood? Because that's not cinema, as we all should be knowing. We're not here to talk about Bollywood as an art form, because that's weak. That's really itchy and pastiche kind of experience that is created for the illiterate and the ignorant. But there is an art form called cinema which is being practiced all over the world. There are 140 nations and they have their masters already, because it's 100 years plus now, the art form. It is a crucible of perhaps all the arts, from classical music or folk, or Natyashastra, or art, kind of comes together in a cauldron. And then after that, burbur, what happens is cinema. So this cinema, why keep it away from children? Because unfortunately, what happens is, even in your art class, with your regular bad art teacher, with the two hills and one sunset, the river and the moon, you know, birds flying, and this jhopri in the foreground. So why limit art to just that? Because mostly the middle class thinks that that's okay, it's a hobby. Mein kya hai, prithvi mein chal raha hai, summer time aake. Then stand one full night to procure that wonderful, most precious form for your child, for your only child, a precious child, and then fight as a father and mother should, so that the child gets more than the next child. You know, this kind of I myself, that is kind of, you know, working so hard in our lives, is really, really limiting the scope for children. So in that light, I would talk about a 7-year-old little girl who 8 years ago came into this cinema class in a municipal school where I was sitting, which I had kind of initiated. But I was not teaching, I was learning as much as the children were, because we were sharing the masters, not on such a fancy screen. We had one white color chadar which had some marks on it and the wrinkles, and through those wrinkles and marks we've seen Gopika Zaveel and Fateh Panchali. And I've seen that the children from that municipal school, many of whom are not don't have a favorable roof on their head, absorb as if they were hungry for a month, not moving an inch while watching Durga and So that really chokes me. That is my calling card. I found my calling card. I said, this is where I should be. So in one such encounter, very early in the cinema class, maybe 6 months away from when it began, this little girl, we were doing screenplay that particular Saturday. Saturday evenings, 4 to 6, was the class off school time, but in the school. So I said, children, you have to write like a 3-scene screenplay. First we had started with 1 scene. We had ripped Charlie Chaplin, the kid. So we saw the whole film, then we saw it for the scenes, then we saw it for the shots, then we saw it for the edits, we saw it for the writer's intent. And many, many such visitations, finally to digest Chaplin's kid completely. So that at the end of that experience, we knew why Chaplin was doing what he was. From age 6 to age 14. All of us want
to see.
It's open and voluntary. It's not just voluntary. You can walk in and walk out also. So you don't have to sign a muster. You might perhaps find that in the dark room with the fan on top of your head, you might want to doze off. You're allowed to. So nobody is holding you to, are you maximizing? In that class. So it's an open class. We start with dal chawal, so that cinema on an empty stomach is not good. And then we graduate to viewing films, talking about them, writing scenes, executing them. This little girl brought in this 3-scene screenplay for me, read it out in the class. So she said, scene number 1. This is in Asima in Pali Chimba Municipal School. Try as you may, talk in Hindi with them, they will reply to you. That's the stunning beauty of the child. So the child here says, scene number 1 is that of a man in an office, and he's getting a telephone call to say that his wife is delivering. So he keeps the phone down and he runs down the staircase of the office building. He hails a auto rickshaw, and scene number 1 is over. Scene number 2 is, he sits in the auto rickshaw, and is the journey from inside the auto rickshaw, and also at certain points where you see the auto rickshaw passing. It comes into a narrow lane, and unfortunately, the way is blocked because a lot of people are standing and obstructing the traffic. So the man jumps out of his rickshaw and goes to see what is the matter. And he finds that there's a large python lying across the lane. And people are fussing about it because the python is not dead, it's alive, but it's kind of just lying there, senseless perhaps. So the driver, he tells the rickshaw driver, chhodna, just drive, man. So against a lot of objections, the man makes the auto driver drive over the python, and it's a cut, it's a detailed shot of the stomach splitting open, and you see some eggs of the python. He reaches the hospital, scene 3 begins, the man runs up the stairs, so there's a detail, stair 1, stair 2, stair 3, stair 4. And he can hear the wailing of a newborn getting louder and louder as he reaches the third floor. Finally, he reaches the third floor, enters a room where his wife is passed out, tired, and next to her is a blanket under which baby is and it's kind of flailing arms and legs, so moving all around. So he rushes there and he pulls off the blanket to reveal that the baby has snake skin. And of course that's the end of the story. The three lines came. So this is a 6.5 to 7 year old girl who is now strapping 15 there in the city. So we are Qureshi. I brought her here because post that she has made many, many films. Not just writing screenplays, but commanding a unit, a set, commanding actors. So I'll just bring in her first her film and the making of one of her films, so that we are on the same page and I'm not just yakking about it. And then of course she will speak. Why should I be speaking? If lights can be put out, then it's
just like this. One more talk.
You check the sound alarm?
Yes.
अंडी, अंडी,
मुझे पता है आज क्या हुआ? मैंने ज्योति के बैग में चुप करी डाली, वो इतना जोर से चिल्लाई कि टीचर ने उसे ही बाहर निकाल दिया।
बंटी, चलो जाओ, छत से कपड़े लेके आओ, हवा बहुत तेज चल रही है।
ज्योति वाजे क्लास के बाहर खड़ी थी बालों में 1 किलो तेल के साथ।
बोला ना जाके कपड़े लेके आओ।
मैं नहीं लेने वाला।
जाता है कि लगाऊं तो झापड़?
जाता हूँ, बस डांटना आता है।
One more time so that you can Is it a yes or a no?
Yes.
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 पीछे कितनी मेहनत है क्योंकि मैं तो फिल्म देखती थी, मैं सिर्फ एक्टिंग देखती थी।
और एक्टर्स लोग भी लाइक अच्छे ही रहे, पर एक्टर्स लोग में सिर्फ एक्टिंग थी और जो बिहाइंड पूरा जो ग्रुप था वो लोगों का तो कुछ दिखाई नहीं देता टीवी पे, जो एक्टिंग की उनका ही नाम होता था। इसलिए मैं चाहती थी कि मैं डायरेक्टिंग बनूँ और डायरेक्टिंग को आगे लाऊँ।
तो सबसे पहला तुम्हारा घर का पार्ट होगा, तुम आओगे सिटी मारते मारते, फिर तुम देखोगे कि यह एक लड़की रो रही है और वो कौन रहेंगी, रिद्धि। इनका डायलॉग हो गया, फिर तुम इधर जाओगे जब तक सिद्धि ये दरवाजे से निकल कर लिफ्ट में पहुंच कर टेरिस पे पहुंचोगे, जो मैं ऊपर डिस्कस की थी। अब हम जेल में प्रैक्टिस करते हैं। तो सबसे पहले सिद्धार्थ तुम उधर जाओ और वॉक करके आओ, और रिद्धि तुम इधर बैठो, इस सीढ़ी पे बैठोगे, ठीक है? और सिद्धार्थ कम, यू विल बी सेल एंड यू विल कम, देन सिद्धि रिद्धि रिद्धि ना, सो यू तुम इधर बैठोगे और तुम्हारा यहाँ डायलॉग होगा। तुम बोलोगे तुम
20 साल से,
या फर्स्ट तुम पहले क्राई करोगे, देन यू विल चेंज योर एक्सप्रेशन कि ये डरना चाहिए, ठीक है? और जब तुम शॉर्ट कैसे लोगे, जब हम इधर जाएंगे जब तक रिद्धि तुम एग्जिट डोर लोगे और लिफ्ट में जाकर फोर्थ फ्लोर पे पहुंच जाओगे और वह अपना पोजीशन ले लेना, ठीक है? जस्ट आई वांटेड टू ऐड अ लाइक क्राइंग सीन, लाइक अ साउंड ऑफ घोस्ट व्हिच इज क्राइंग। Yeah, I know to make that sound, so that's why I just wanted to earn it. So that. Firstly, I'll show them two sisters so that I can take a single shot. अगर direct direct चल रहे ना तो लोगों को लगेगा अरे हाँ ऐसा कैसा हो गया कि कल भी नहीं किया ये लड़की यहाँ कैसे आ गई। अभी हम क्या करेंगे, हम सिद्धार्थ को पता नहीं चलने लगे कि लिफ्ट चालू है, लेकिन हम ये नोटिस लगाएंगे लिफ्ट पे कि लिफ्ट बंद है, सो दैट ही डोंट कम टू नो कि लिफ्ट चालू है एंड ही डोंट यूज इट। My father is an auto driver, my mom is a housewife, and my grandmother goes to work. Mera nickname ki Chand, ki like my forehead is weak, so they call me like Chand, half Chand. My dad says that badi pishani kismat ki nishani, so I always remember that. आई लाइक फुटबॉल फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, क्योंकि मेरे को उसमें ज़्यादा भाव भी देते रहेंगे, मैं अच्छा भी खेलती हूँ फुटबॉल, और मेरे को लड़कियाँ बिल्कुल नहीं पसंद, जो वैसी लड़कियाँ जो एकदम लाइक नाजुक चाले कर रहे हैं, लाइक अगर कुत्ता भूख भी देगा तो लाइक चिल्लाते जो लड़का जो इतना बड़ा कुछ हो गया। बॉस स्कूल में आई एम द लाइक अ बॉस, क्योंकि जो भी मेरे फ्रेंड में जो ग्रुप है तो हम लोग के ग्रुप का नाम है डैजलर्स। सो लाइक अगर कुछ भी परेशानी होती है ना, मैं और एक लड़का है सनत नाम का,
और इसको बोलते हैं। फिर अगर कितने भी हम लोग जेठ खाते सब लोग मिलकर जाके धोते हैं।
मैं ऐसे
करके
सिखाने करती हूँ
तुम्हारे
knowledge
and build up a story and make up a film. So that's what I believe. Questions?
Yeah, the friends of yours who made it.
My friends. Like I had brother. Your John. Brother? But Ashish Aikwad.
Yeah, they know Ashish. He's coming. They've seen Kahan.
Firstly, when we used to go to Amsa's class, there was a group of like director group. I was the smallest among them. So like when these films came, Blackboard, then very Iranian films and all, that went all over my head. But still I said, what is it? Then slowly like I started getting impressed. And I came to know the real meaning of art, which I feel comfortable. Like studying, I'm good at studying, but I don't like to study. So if even I get good percentage in 10, but I will not choose science or commerce. I will only choose art.
Very nice. So what are you working on now? Are you working on a movie now? Are you working on a movie?
Yeah. Now there is 3 months holiday, so I will look up forward to shoot the film.
Very nice.
What made you get interested in the ghost? The idea of a ghost, how did that come to you?
Ghost. Actually, Amusar made me a meeting with Holix. It was for Holix. So they told me we are making a creative children's film. They gave the story and I had to shoot it.
Not your story, the whole story. No. I mean, you didn't write the story.
No.
It's a director.
You directed.
Yeah, I did.
But then you wanted that long, continuous shot.
Yeah.
That was your idea.
Do you also write?
Yeah, I like stories. I like stories. I like poems. I like to write. So whenever I write a new book, I start scribbling over it.
She's part of the NCUBE library. Right?
Did art introduce you to revolution?
Sorry?
Did art introduce you towards to revolution? I mean, do you have any idea about it into your writing?
Revolution? Yes. Is that
what you're asking? Yeah. Did art introduce her to revolution? Of film industry.
Yes, of course. Because when I was not in this thing, I saw films like actions, dramas, or over. So like that is not real. And what I felt was real. So like after getting into these classes, I changed my way of thinking and seeing the things. It's like what around me is real, but what not what is shown on the film. So cinema is the art of living, not of like anything, entertainment.
That's revolutionary enough.
Yeah, yeah, that's why.
Can't put in a better issue. Perfectly.
How Charlie Chaplin's looked after that kid and like a perfect story for which I see in my surroundings.
Did you see that movie Thingya? Thingya. Have you seen it? Thingya?
No.
You must see it. Definitely check it out. It's a Marathi movie. It's about a small boy. We're talking about realism and reality. Let's see that. Okay?
But have you seen Ayat?
Which one?
Ayat.
Ayat. You must see it.
I will.
Hayat is also one of the
What is Hayat in? I don't know of the film. What is Hayat?
It is an Iranian film. Hayat, even I do not know the meaning, but seeing Hayat, I think so it means like how there are many problems and you take a relief, breathe after after getting a solution for all the problems. So getting a relief, breathe means Hayat. Means in Muslims, when anyone expires, we say "Inko hayati ho gayi." Like he has a taken relief breath. So like something.
Is the name of the protagonist? Yeah. The little girl who in university manages to give her examination just like Sonia does on an everyday basis. It's an exam for her. It's that kind of very, very simply told, but fabulously moving people. Wanting to continue in the education stream despite obstacles.
Current day, huh?
Current day.
What do you want to do when you go?
Do
you want to go to film school in
Sydney
or film school?
After that, I would like to go to Sydney or
you're going to mainstream cinema or continue going like these? What is your interest in? What is your interest in like mainstream cinema or you'll do like independent films like this?
I want to make independent films. I want to start on my feet alone and save the world.
That's the daughter I have.
We'd
that's
love
why
to
I'm a very intelligent person to others.
Put up a notice in the library, we'll make sure we get
it. Films, including documentaries, that can
come. Yeah. Whatever is your future work, I'd love to see what you're doing.
Just one question. When you, the person who was working with you, your cameraman, I haven't seen his other work, you talked about him, right? Who shot your film?
No, he's just an operative.
He's just an operator, not one of your group
students. No. That is that Neeraj Gevan's team.
Okay.
But not cameraman. He's just an operative. He's not Neeraj Gevan's cameraman.
Okay.
So that was a facility made available. But yeah, ready-made directors will have
to.
So they kind of, put it out there commercially, of course. So commercially means on the net and all external. But actually, it's a very Sujava director's work that we just saw. And
how many documentaries have you created?
Which is not one. When you saw this, and Gifted's Night, that was my own. And others were made by a group of directors.
I think we should show them Asubhane Moti. Did we?
At that time we were very small.
Did we show
earlier
Asubhane Moti with Tahan? No. No, they're not running. Do you want to see Asubhane Moti?
How long? We should see it.
Great. Come. Well spoken, my friend.
I said, please leave the class immediately. Please leave the class. Get out of the class.
Thank you.
तेरा अनुभव अच्छा लगेगा। ए तुम भी सताने का नहीं, तुम भी सताया तो
processes, or if doubt in your mind. Because has any one of you seen Kahan apart from the regular people? Ashish precedes her in age. He is the first student in the cinema class. And after a point, he was, of course, independent in his heart and mind, just like Surya is. And what he did was, to surprise me on my birthday, he used my entire unit, my office, my edit, camera, whatever, something. He used to ask me a strange question. Sir, what have I come to the office today? So I used to answer him. Then this happened 4 or 5 times, and I was wondering why he was asking these silly questions. When you're going back, how is that day, doctor? Then on my birthday, he presented me a film called Tahan. Tahan means thirst in Marathi. And it's a beautiful film. So wherever I went to SRFTI and all the skin groups or FTI, I carried that film of his with me for the masterclass. And at one point, the Whistling Woods faculty, why she's saying Whistling Woods, you will get an idea why she's using that institution. Because there is a precedent. So Ashish Gaikwad, whose film Tahan was shown to the Whistling Woods faculty and students, that film kind of viral into the corridors of the administrators and all. And on that completion of 100 years of cinema and the 3-day event at Whistling Woods, the wrap of that event was Tahan was shown as the closing film of the 3-day event. And Subhash Ghai got Dada Saheb Phalke's grandson and Ashish Gaikwad. And his mother were called on stage. His mother was widowed when he was 4 years old. Father was a municipal sweeper. So the mother got the job. So from age 4, Ashish went with her on the beat of cleaning the roads of Mumbai. And simultaneously grew up to be a very good artist. Sole also is a fabulous painter, also a sister. They are wonderful painters. They can talk about Bangkok. They can talk about Renaissance. So, well, this lot is favored to have met them. Moral of the story is that on that day, Subhash Ghai handed out a wonderful gift to Ashish Gaikwad, a 100% free scholarship, which is a 17-18 lakh rupee course. And he said that this is, Ashish will be doing us a big favor, having made this film. He will bring his point of view and thoughts into the classroom, and we'll be favored by his presence in our institution. Well, he's out now, he's trying to make films, and he would have been here, except that his mother required him in the village, so he and his mother are in the village. But we can share that film if you want. Yes. Some of them have seen the film. But it's better to see what they do rather than, you know, thinking.
Yes,
Ashish Gaikwad's Tahan. किसका सर है ये बचाओ भाई लंबे बाल वाले सवाल कटिंग इन टू द फ्रेम What they present?
It's...
What happened, bro?
No, the letter is leaking on the both sides.
It's leaking?
Yeah, the picture is...
Thank you.
Thank you.
it's like a red vault and I don't think we need to really, really define what would be achieved by defining the rest of our culture. Is it a worthy film or not is the question. You know what I feel. Because sometimes you get caught in the jargon. Unnecessary trappings of quasi-learning. This is just unnecessary classifying things. When a very pure document of great strength, showing the great divide, that is part of our reality. I think that is why it would be a favorite film for a film-loving audience or a cinema-loving audience, because his investment in the image is so solid, the way it has it pans out. And as an eternal student of cinema, I can tell you that I'm always thirsty for such good mixes, molds. Because it's important that we realize that right now where it's turning to is turning to the us and them, which is also a concern for me, which is why I don't make myself so readily available to the us. Because they can always pay the money and get the fellows. But I feel that there is very little opportunity existing on the other side. And that's very, very frightening, because it's a readily available and acceptable truth that, yeah, carpentry is good for the poor, vocational is good for the poor. That's no good. So what should we be doing at this moment? Because I'm kind of getting choked, both with the belt and the
We could open it out to questions and the
yes.
conversation.
I also want you to realize and take the thought home. And how you can participate in whatever skills you have, and how you can bring it into society, which does not get an option to even have knowledge of the skills. And I feel very proud when Surya talks about the art form with such stability and understanding of what she is speaking, every sentence weighed and full of meaning. How many of us exercise that economy and restraint while we... That's a question to answer yourself. Because I need to bring it time and again to the table. Because I need to show the disparity. Question.
So, I have a question. Like you said, the gap is widening, and it's easier for the middle class to get it going and happening. But honestly, for someone who has no connect or in this, how maybe there's a lot of potential around, there's a lot of talent around, but how do you get to the right place so that your talent could be utilized?
For me, I've always imagined, which is why we are in our ninth year. I was working with Asima. I don't know how many people of you are connected with Asima. I'm a little cutty with Asima because the school threw out one of my children for other reasons. And the reasons were flimsy. And nobody has a right to take a child out of education. So right now, I'm a little worried when I'm talking that I've had a friendship and investment with that. With an organization which I have found always sturdy and supporting children. But suddenly there seems to be no empathy for the child who is now out of the system. Thankfully, with a little pool, I managed to get a seat for him in Springfield. So he go to a regular school, but he has lost him. to answer your question, that when I was sitting there for 8 years, and evenly listening and speaking and reacting the way the children were, because there were some new ways that they were looking at the same film, and maybe with my old ideas and my ideas of Tarkovsky and Kieslowski, maybe it was not necessary to, you know, run it through that intellectual filter. So they kind of simplified the same films for me. So I can safely say they were my teachers in those encounters, my new teachers. Having said that, I feel that the only way to democratize cinema is to put it as an education subject in your regular curriculum. I mean, the geography or the history textbook writer doesn't come to your classroom. The textbook comes to your classroom. So it's, if you bring in the grades, like I would seriously suggest to start the curriculum with Dho Bigha Zameen. So you understand your mitti, you understand crisis. Children are kind of getting waned off because from air-conditioned home to air-conditioned school bus to air-conditioned school. So it's becoming a club. And the more that happens, for I me myself not, it's going to be a linked existence. So then what will you create? So you'll create Dil Dharakne Do. What kind of crisis is that? Dil Chahta Hai. Three fully grown men in Zindagi Na Milegi Dobara are acting like perfect delinquent children and scaring unawares people in the toilet. I feel short of words, you know, to see this dumbness kind of spreading like an epidemic. It might be accepted by a part of this audience also. And say, wow, man, that was like really rocking. But is it really, really necessary for this nation? I can understand the progressive Scandinavian nations. They all eat well, they all sleep well. Their problems are different. But here, you know, if you can buy $1,000 or $500 multiplex ticket, only then you qualify for that kind of entertainment. So then the filmmakers also be going to be very aware that this is the kind of entertainment I got to design for these blokes who will spend $200 on a tub of water. Is it really, really the correct route we are taking? Because you keep talking about empathy and CSR and this and that, but it all seems to be a jhol. It seems to be kind of washing the laundry after you've eaten the dessert. Then what kind of trickles down. So that's not a healthy society. That way I would like to always try and engage in this kind of an encounter with this strata of society, because otherwise there'll be no hope. So it is very difficult to get out of a slum. You know, it's easy to get out of a one-bedroom apartment to a three-bedroom apartment, which I was able to do in my lifetime. But it's very difficult to get out of one hovel and get reduced to rubble. Time and again, we're told that you are nothing and no value for the life. And that's not how the Lord we accept. There's some problem. So more empathetic or more thought-provoking stuff that will happen, which used to happen in the past. Why am I saying Dho Bigha Zameen? What a handsome father he had. Proper suit, lovely accent. Why was he doing Dho Bigha Zameen? Why was he doing Bandini? Why was he doing Sujata? He should have also been like Zoya and Farhan. You know, nice, eating well, of the nice table, lovely bungalow. No. That's not how Vishantaram also behaved. That's not how Vishnupan Tamil behaved. That's not how Fakilal behaved. So there's something wrong since the 70s. And we are very happily accepting this change in cinema. So So if it is meant to be genuinely a playground for children, then the real cinema has to come. Otherwise there is no hope. If you say Kurosawa, it might sound like just a sound to a huge lot of your population. And it's not their fault. Within the education stream there should be, it should come in. If you're talking about the Mediterranean and you're talking about the tundras and North Pole and South Pole, then you can well start off with Nanak of the North.
But why do you think education doesn't include cinema as a part of their...
That's a shame. I tried. I was, for a while, I was chairperson of this Children's Film Society. I tried my level best to first make it child friendly, get rules. Because otherwise children are like being enslaved by the... It's a child labor thing in the reality shows and all the shows where they participate. There's no... The child is actually at the lowest of the...
Cinema as an art form is much more expensive than another art form. Like, see, Rowan write a book or Rowan make a film. It's a world of difference in how much expense goes into it. So,
but now it is different. Your phone can answer your questions. You can make a film on a phone.
I was quite surprised to hear that you said that the mode has changed since the 70s. I thought you would be saying that since the 90s perhaps that it was, because the society as such...
It's a slow boiling change from 70s to 90s, where the anti-hero became the hero.
Okay,
and
you
started
sense.
Celebrating lifestyle in Diva, and Adi Mastan became the hero of the nation.
But when you speak about showing crisis to children, do you think it's also important to show their humor and the importance of that kind of film?
No, children are not some animal species.
Exactly.
Us one.
Yeah.
Our children.
Yeah.
So why should we fear? Why only entertainment?
But I'm
saying
why only crisis?
Why am I saying that? Did I say crisis? I said at the crisis. Humans are getting a lot, getting a well fed with silly humor. You know? And that also is not humor. I mean, if I was. I have shared Jaane Bhi Do Yaar with my children and so many times, and how much we've laughed for the right reason. So it depends on how you develop that taste from the crass to the really funny. So which is why she's talking about Chaplin, she'll talk about Buster Keaton, Marx Brothers, or even old Kishore Kumar. It's funny enough. She's not offensive, that kind of thing. But there has to be some parhez, you know. Because if you don't do that parhez, then it's badhaz, interesting. So you have to, you know, take it at that, in that quantity. Otherwise, when you know all is not well, why do you shout all is well? That's like lying, you know, to your children, to your next generation. So how will that girl know that there's a life existing apart from, you know, hobbies and tennis and swimming? There has to be some sensitivity and selection.
So by choosing the films that you show them, yes, how will you judge? Because ultimately you will try to, I'm feeling it, you'll be trying to show the films that you like, or
no.
Maybe
I also have a filter, because I have a responsibility towards 14-year-olds and down under to 6. So I have to be extremely careful. In fact, we do so many scans and runs of each film. And something like Pocket Money, I couldn't show. Because there might be an objectionable shot, which is...
Yeah, besides that, I felt she was talking about Iranian cinema at some time, because usually it's very simple. But when you give it a thought, it's like layers and layers of thought.
So it's good or it's bad?
It is good, but I don't know whether they get all the things that
you're doing.
No. I'm just saying
that.
How do you guide them into
the whole understanding of it.
मैं तो बोल रहा हूँ वो नहीं गाइड नहीं आप उल्टा बोल रहे हो. मैं तो कह रहा हूँ कि वो मेरे को गाइड कर. They see it so differently. When for instance when Solia starts this, you know, giving a dissertation of a film, the way she has looked into the film is learning from me. And I have like literally grown like a banyan tree at the Film Institute. So on a daily staple diet of 3 masterpieces a day, for 12 years, I've kind of grown fat with cinema knowledge. Still, I don't want to vacate that student's seat. I don't want to be a master. So the truth be told, that this is different.
Yeah,
because
she knows not many things that I was in awe when I was
with her. Absolutely. Because if you're aware that you're in awe, chances are that you're a sensitive person and you understand what is being said here. And if you're condescending and say, oh, achi, achi, okay.
she was never a bachi to me.
Correct.
When she was
well said. What's your name?
Deepa.
Rajuli. So that's true. That's the truth.
Because I thought of the single shot that she was talking, yeah. I was absolutely mesmerized that okay, because she knows that.
She chose the twins. So that.
Yeah.
वो बात आई.
That suspension of this.
Twins लियो किया इधर से इधर भेजा उधर से उसको भेजा उसको. पांच मर्तबा तो सेम चेहरा देख रहे हो एक ही शॉट में. क्या प्रिंटेड से क्या है? नहीं देखते. Twins है, but usage देखते. तो वो अकल से और अवेयरनेस से बात हुई. वो ऐसे ही कोइंसिडेंटल नहीं है. द अमाउंट ऑफ आइडियाज ऑफ हाउ नॉट टू जंप द एक्सिस, आई डोंट नो इफ एनीबडी अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट आई एम टॉकिंग हियर, बट इट्स अ प्योरली टेक्निकल टर्म. बट द आइडिया वी टोल्ड दैट इफ टू पीपल आर टॉकिंग टू ईच अदर, इट द आईबॉल शुड बी इन सच अ पोजिशन दैट इट लुक्स ऑन द स्क्रीन दैट दे आर टॉकिंग टू ईच अदर. Where you say that you don't jump the axis because then it will create as if they are talking to a third person who is out of frame and you never get to see him. Till the film ends, you don't know who that third person is. I can identify you national awarding directors who don't know this person. And I don't want to pitch them up, but the truth is there are so many flaws which my children will never know.
Because what I'm trying to learn here is the process that you tell them or the way you direct them. Because I have tried myself, you know, learning.
You know, I'll tell you frankly, FTI में कहा होता है कि मेरे और फेलिनी के बीच में कोई नहीं आ सकता.
वाया.
फेलिनी. मेरे और फेलिनी do not pass the. फेलिनी नाम है. Ben Affleck के बीच में. Ben Affleck. तो कहने का तात्पर्य ये है कि when you are talking to the master and the master is talking to you in the darkness of a theater, बीच का चुचुंदर टीचर कौन है? इसमें फिल्म बनाई है? नहीं बनाई. वो सिर्फ वाह 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 बोलता है. उसको तो एक्सपीरियंस ही नहीं है. फ्लोर क्या चीज होती है? शॉर्ट कैसे एक्टर को क्या होता है? वो तो फिर बोल रहा है कि हाँ उसने फेलिनी ने ऐसा किया और कुरोसावा ने ऐसा किया और ग्रेट मास्टर ने ऐसा. आई डोंट वांट टू शो माय नॉलेज. बट स्टूडेंट बोलता है कुछ चुप कर मैं देख रहा हूँ. तो मेरा जिम्मा ही है कि स्टूडेंट और स्क्रीन के बीच में नहीं आ, सिर्फ शेयर कर, फिर उनके दिमाग को सैल्यूट कर, क्योंकि वो अंदर ले ग्रहण हो रहा है. दैट इज व्हाट इट इज. एब्सॉर्प्शन इज द बेस्ट वे टू ब्रिंग इट आउट. सो देयर इज नो रॉकेट साइंस. द मोर यू सी द मास्टरपीस योर गूगल अवे टू द जापानीज सिनेमा. आ गए सर. So what is going to stop a student from watching the best that is offered by the world and not a product? A product itself. प्रोडक्ट की बात, फिर अबाउट सिनेमा आर्ट फॉर्म। 100 साल के मास्टर्स हैं अभी, हर प्रांत के, हर रीजन के मास्टर। उन्होंने टिंगिया बोला किधर के हड़ौले, मेरे को भी हड़ौले हो गया। कौन बोला टिंगिया के बारे में? किसी ने बोला? बच्चे को टिंगिया देगा क्या? चले गए क्या? अच्छी फिल्म थोड़ा, पर उसमें थोड़ा ऑब्जेक्शनेबल है इसलिए मैं सर एकदम फुल नहीं चाह रहा। दैट्स व्हाई अदरवाइज देयर इज इन फैंट्री।
So, can you share your must-see list?
Last because I'm a film student, so essentially there's so much. वरना आज एक काम कर सकते हैं आप, वो ब्लॉग है उनका, जुनून का ब्लॉग है, उसपे है मेरी विश लिस्ट तो है उसको।
हाँ हाँ आपकी विश लिस्ट है, वी पुट इट
ऑन आज का। ये भी कोई है क्या है? हिंदू टुडेज़ हिंदू has a smaller list than what they have. They have a bigger list.
Yeah, we have about 21 films which are this must-see films.
Yeah.
How
would
JunoonTheater.wordpress.com.
So it's there, it's not like it's not there. And it's great fun. Because kya hota hai? Wo purani baat keh raha hu, samajh mein aa rahi hai. Jaise main apne pitaji ko idolize karke padha, वो इतना सा था तो मेरे को सवाई गंधर्व ले गए, या कोई बैठक है भीमसेन जोशी बड़े सालों ले जाते, मैं बैठ जाता, फुल फेथ इन माई फादर, वॉट ही इज ओपनिंग आउट टू मी इज ऑफ ग्रेट वैल्यू, सो इट काइंड ऑफ होल्ड माई अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ इंडियन क्लासिकल। My neighbor used to ridicule. अरे क्या हुआ? तो अभी मैं उसको क्या बोलूँ? So it is continuous exposure that we are talking about. Now my father didn't go to Rabindranath Institution to, or he didn't go to Uday Shankar Institution. He didn't go to Sangeet Bhava. He was just a simple computer scientist who had great liking into theatre, because I am a Maharashtra, 300 years of Sangeet theatre, everything. So the Savai and the Bal and the Chota, everything is part of my DNA. Then he had to be a Rasik. No, that's not mine, that's the children's. I wouldn't say that's mine. So, in a sense, if you are open to the art forms, and if it's a collective of those art forms, that's cinema. Because, like once Mr. Vijayanand told, I had gone there as a humble boy to interview him for Cinematographers Combined. He said, cinema is architecture and motion. The more you eat it, the more you'll be weaned away from the rubbish. You will not look for the rubbish. It's the dime a dozen magazines. But the day you kind of start chewing into those things, then how can you pick up that film fairly? You will not, your hand won't go, the children don't pick up anything less than a masterpiece. Value system, and it's always good. It's good to exercise that in our lives also. So what is being consumed and how it is going to help us, do we really know what is going to happen to us when we breathe our last? I would like to meet that person who educated me about it. So not knowing the code and yet being so, I mean, so tucha. Why would you want to be a tucha in life? Why would you want to waste one life that has been gifted to you? It's much more. Much more than cinema also, I would say. Cinema is a tool. You can't take it so seriously that you get anal about it. There's nothing. It's an art form. That's it.
We have time for two more questions.
Only two.
We're out of time.
Raining is your question. Two few?
Yeah, na. Questions always come together.
How long have you been working with the children?
I don't know.
Long time.
I've never worked on youth animation. I've been with the children. We shared cinema. But it's now in our 9th year.
So my question is two part. The second part is, do you see a difference in the rest of their education? Like, do they do better due to this interaction that your organization has with them? And other subjects?
Do they get better at rote learning?
And other subjects.
I don't know. I'm not assessing that. Well, I don't want to judge them.
No, I don't ask as a matter of judgment. I just think it's because you're giving them that external exposure, which they generally wouldn't get. Are they doing better in other parts of their life as well? That's what.
Yeah, as she spoke, would be giving you an indication of what she has answered the question.
So, both the films that we saw today, there's a kind of organic reality that's displayed. And I was working in rural development in an organization in Madhya Pradesh, and there also they have a filming department which makes such organic films. What do you think stops these films to reach out to the... You've spoken a lot about it in this session. What do you think this stops... these kind of films are not widely distributed.
Yes.
Because, as you mentioned, Do Bigha Zameen,
so
Mother India...
So, what do you mean Jangle in Madhya Pradesh? Do Jangle?
No.
He heads that department that you talk about. So, there are good people in good places.
Yeah.
And what will good work? The only dushman, if I can say, of the distribution of such films is the mindset of the viewers. It's a demand-supply curve. You know, I'm graced and lucky that with some amount of value skill, I have managed to bring back the investment on the films that I have produced. Tarizami Par I have not produced, but Sadli Ka Dabba and Hawa Hawai I have produced. And I brought back the money, which was quite a sum, in both the ventures. Which goes into, if I were to give you a fair balance, like 10 crores for Hawa Hawai coming back. And 5.5 for Satellite and other things. Now, I don't think my film was such a great film. There were other films which are as good, like I Am Kalam, which I liked so much. And it was also put all around in terms of it tied up with Century Ply. So we had huge holdings of I Am Kalam at its release. So that means publicity was also happening simultaneously. It's not like it was not publicized. But it brought back 65 lakhs. Out of which more than half will go to the exhibit. The guy who runs the film. How discouraging can that be? And then we say there are no films, but we don't have a film. And there are films for children, people don't take a treat. There are some films. You go to a European nation, you go to say Finland, or you go to Norway. The films made for children attract more audiences than films made for adults, for the certification group 18 and above. That means parents are literally, you know, this is why I asked the question, ki aap log to aaye apne bacche kahan hain? बच्चे दिख रहे अच्छा लग रहा है क्योंकि बच्चे नहीं तो फिर क्या मजा है वी हैव अ हैबिट है वो यूए है ना चलो चलो साथ में लेके जाए पॉपकॉर्न खिलो हफ्ते भर का शुगर और हफ्ते भर का सॉल्ट कोक का इतना बड़ा मतलब 5,000 रुपये खर्चा नहीं करेंगे तो ऐसा लगेगा कि नींद नहीं आएगी जितना महंगा टिकट उतना ज्यादा डिमांड वीकेंड तो ऐसे माहौल में कौन देखेगा काम कर आई क्लेवरली वोमेन स्केट्स मेड लाइक अ Ferrari flows. Otherwise, I was telling the dead farmer's son story. Who would have come? Vidarbha ka abhu ke Saturday entertainment hona chahiye re. Entertainment. Oh, because that was a uniform. So every mother who sends a tiffin with the child feels my worth. But out of the education system, out of the middle class existence, you show a chai boy in Rajasthan. Who else is? That's the sad part of living in India. You have to first acknowledge it, and then if you want, you can work towards change. It used to not be like this. Because I mean, it's a hit film. Mother India is a hit film. Sujata Vandaniya, films that have been celebrated by the very Indian audiences. Do Aankhe Barahar. Dr. Kotnis Ki Amar Gaan. These kind of films.
It's still showing on television all this
time. Television is okay. It's a monster. It requires to be fed.
Even when it's shown today, people are glued to it.
Yes, absolutely.
You cannot get up while you're watching Bandhu.
Exactly. I mean, the last feeling I got like that was in Laga. Like, you know, otherwise, the Barbie doll cinema had won. If Laga wouldn't have been released, we would be ensured Dharma production and Yes, right. The pink bedrooms and the silly things about silly people. That's a shame.
But I think you can love a Bandhani and a wake-up sin, although they are very different kinds of cinema.
No, wake-up sin is about us, no? Naturally,
exactly,
we love.
Exactly, but you still love Bandhani, right? Or Sujata for that.
I don't know. Bandhani might have not reached the next gen. Only a, meaning a, like a foodie, a cinema lover will find his or her ways and means to reach the masters. But otherwise, how will you? Maybe the reality shows do a little bit of good, the singing types, because they re-evoke some old songs and, you know, kind of brings it into the stream. But baki 90s, you're right, it's after the 90s only the crash. The true crash. Of food, yes.
We made a lot of change movies, the animation movies. So sometimes the animation industry, what is the idea behind it? So many movies are still
in India? No, like Finding Nemo and they're fabulous. So if you see the wisdom of John Lasseter, or see the wisdom of Pixar animation studio. He makes Love Bug, or sorry, Bug's Life, and DreamWorks makes Ants. Scary brown thingies. It was a flop. It had the best voices. It had Stallone, it had Woody Allen, it had all of them.
Teaching the children to animation is a better,
real. Not real animation, whatever. My most favorite film is Finding Nemo. It is, because it is giving you the values and it is giving you high-end animation.
I think, don't you mean that Indian animation, whenever there's a
Disneyfied
kind of an animation?
No, you're so right. Like, I would have loved to show Printed Rainbow.
Oh, lovely.
Of Patanjali Rao, if anybody has seen it. Mm-hmm. Or you can go to the net, I think it's
on YouTube.
Printed Rainbow. Talks about such beautiful core values, but this studio the villain is a reality. So either it's that or it's not. You're so right. So in such a scenario, it's going to be very difficult for Geetanjali Rao to find the support. Even that Gopi Gawaiya Bhaga Bhage, what a beautiful film. It's there on that wish list.
Yeah.
It's a CFSI film, yeah. Children's Film Society. Shilpa Ranade Meja. Beautiful.
She's gone back to the leather puppets, you know. It's so, the artwork is so you relate
stunning
to the Indian art and craft over there. this total avoidance of the Disney-fied kind of animation.
Absolutely. Ramani had made one lovely, R.V. Ramani had made a lovely documentary on leather puppets. Many years ago, 20 years ago. Beautiful documentary. So, until we know our art forms, which were so high-end, what are we doing? You can join Shyamak Daro and dance your head off to Bollywood. But that's okay, that's a good release. I'm not judging Shyamak, he's a dear friend. But you see, the world exists here beyond that. Of course, there's no need to discuss that in this August gathering. People who are so aware. But then this awareness has to be taken to, you know, to the people out there who think Kolhapur Airport is the largest in the world. I see confusion. My friend. Confusion. That Kolhapur Airport is the largest. Hey, but unka perception change karna padega na. To individually jaake karna padega. Aur kisi ne koi to किसी ने मेरे कान में फूक दिया हो तो मैं एक जाके बैठ गया. तो ऐसे लोगों को बैठना चाहिए. लाइफ इज शॉर्ट. और इसी के साथ
समाप्त. आज का मोबाइल लोकल इधर ही समय समाप्त.